Hello and welcome to a second edition of the Bulletin Board, where we cover a number of topics from the past week on the Chicago Bulls, as you can see behind me on our Bulletin Board. The team beginning the month of February tied at the top of the Eastern Conference standings. Let's begin, as we always do, with a pin-worthy quote from the team. This one comes from Billy Donovan. When asked how the Bulls will weigh chemistry when it comes to the trade deadline, perhaps adding some other players, which you might remember gets closer every week. And Donovan recalled a discussion with Bulls Executive VP Arturis Karnišovas when discussing his thoughts on that topic.
I didn't even realize this, is I think that Lonzo, Zach, DeMar, and Vooch, you know, have played a total of 17 games together. And that's not even including Javante's situation. Now, I don't think that we're the only team in the league that has had to deal with this, because I think you have two things that you're dealing with. You're dealing with injuries and COVID. And guys have been in and out. It's not just us. But I think I mentioned that we like our group a lot. We like the chemistry a lot. We want to make sure that that continues. I think chemistry in the locker room is really, really critical. It's important. Certainly, Arturis is always going to look at ways to improve the group. But you don't want to, you know, say, okay, we've improved our talent, but we're not as cohesive and the chemistry is not as good.
Now, the Bulls' chemistry has been strong most of this week as they began with a pair of wins, including that 14-point triumph you see in front of them against the Trail Blazers on Sunday. Then on Tuesday, the Bulls knocked off Orlando at home by 11, giving them 32 wins on the season, their most for a single campaign in 5 years. Then on Thursday night, that quick winning streak stopped despite a late rally in regulation in Toronto. Down by 6 with 2 minutes left, the Bulls got the lead with 8 seconds remaining on a shot clock beating hoop by Nikola Vucevic. But unfortunately, the Raptors tied it on a Scotty Barnes put back a second later, and they won it overtime 127-120. The Bulls are now 32-19 on the season. Now, before the game, the Bulls got some great news when it comes to the All-Star game. Guard Zach LaVine was named a reserve for the Eastern Conference for a second straight season. He narrowly missed out on getting voted in as a starter, and he will join DeMar DeRozan, who is a starter, in Cleveland in mid-February, making it the first time the Bulls will have multiple players in the All-Star game since 2016. But Zach hopes the Bulls' representation won't stop with just him and DeMar.
Time you get honored in that way. A lot of hard work, but it's a, you know, it's an honor to go out there and be there, obviously, with my teammates, you know, in the All-Star game with DeMar, and then Ayo and the Rising Stars game. Hopefully we can get Billy a couple more wins going into the break, and them and the staff and coaches out there, I think that'd be special.
Now, every week on the Bulletin Board, we have a piece of Bulletin Board material we'd like to share. And this week comes from the Bulls' fabulous rookie, who got yet another accomplishment. That would be for Ayo Dosunmu, who's been named to the NBA's Rising Stars event in Cleveland on February 18th as part of All-Star Weekend. The former Morgan Park High School and Illinois star will play with 27 of the best young players in the NBA and the G League. This year features a format change, with the players being divided up into 4 teams and then taking part in a mini tournament coached by NBA legends. Ayo's averaging just under 8 points, 2 rebounds, and 2 assists per contest, and had this to say about what he expects when he arrives at All-Star Weekend in Cleveland.
It's an exciting experience because, you know, 10 years, 20 years down the line, you know, all those guys that would always be remembered as the Rising Stars for this year. So to beat the odds and, you know, work hard, come every day with your work hat on, just believe in God and have faith, you could accomplish anything. It's an exciting experience.
Now, the Bulls center wasn't in the All-Star game for a second straight year and the third time in his career, but he sure played like one this week, and that's why he's the player we're bullish on during this Bulletin Board. After some struggles shooting the past few weeks, Nikola Vucevic corrected himself by hitting 60% of the shots he took from the floor, with efforts of 24, 18, and 30 points this week. He also collected a trio of triple-doubles as well. Vucevic was outstanding on Thursday night against the Raptors, leading the way with 30 points and 18 rebounds, shooting 60% from the floor and, maybe more importantly, 4 of 6 from three-point range. While Nikola was impressive Thursday evening, so was a player who's rotated between the Bulls and the G League this season. We'll go to the bullpen for highlights of his incredible effort, including one play that's gotten some social media attention.
David Johnson steps back in, 14 points, 6 of 10 shooting. We highlighted him. Sabonovic moves past Gill, and the big man Sabonovic.
Marko Simonovic had quite a game for the Windy City Bulls against Raptors 9:05 on the road Thursday night, highlighted by that driving slam in the fourth quarter. Simonovic was the bright spot in the loss for the Windy City Bulls as he scored 24 points on 8 of 10 shooting from the floor while also grabbing 14 rebounds. Marko spent a lot of his year with the Windy City Bulls, but he has appeared in 9 games with the NBA Chicago Bulls this season. Thank you very much for joining us on this edition of the Bulletin Board. It's a busy few days for the Bulls ahead thanks to some schedule changes due to postponements back in December. The Bulls will face the Pacers on Friday night in Indy, the Sixers at home on Sunday afternoon, then turn around and play the Suns at the United Center on Monday evening. We'll recap the big stories of those contests and more on next week's show, but for now, I'm Larry Hawley, and have a wonderful weekend.